Hello everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my YouTube channel, and in this playlist we are talking about React hooks. We have covered a lot. We have covered use effect, use state, use reducer, and we also have covered use context. Now in this video we are going to talk about use reducer and use context hook together, because this is like one of the good fit where we can have some kind of a mini store in our application if we are not using Redux. Okay, so let's see the code. This is the code which we have written in the previous video. What we created is a context, shared context, and in the shared context we put this blog and set blog methods, and in the child method, with the help of use context, we are able to consume both the methods. We are able to get the blogs, and on the button click we are able to call the set blog method. Okay, coming back to this, now let's see that this particular state currently, which is we are getting from use state hook. Now instead of that, if we use reducer here, then what we need to change is replace use state with use reducer. Rest all implementations are going to be the same. So like if you just it is something else. Okay, here I will be using use reducer. It will be some having initial state. Okay, here I will get a state and dispatch. State and dispatch, and I will pass state and dispatch both in this object. Okay, and I can get this state and dispatch in my child component. And I will be able to access the use reducer state, and I will be able to call the dispatch method to the reducer function. Okay, let's clean this up and let's try to start from the beginning. That will help you to understand it. Now what we are going to write. Okay, this is my function. Consider that I'm going to write a counter function. Counter is actually updating the counter. And here we have, I can just have a snippet so I can just update it. So this is my counter component. Either you write a function or you can use the anonymous variable const counter. So we created a counter component. It is doing onClick method. Now what we will do is how we can get these count values from a particular parent component. Okay, so for doing this we'll create app component. App component will render this counter component. Okay, just to make it little faster, I'll just copying the code snippet which I already have. So this is the counter component, and I'm trying to access the count value here. So what I can do is I will be creating a shared context, right? In that shared context you can pass, you can create a provider, and this child component can access this state using use context. So what I'm doing is shared context dot provider, just wrap it inside a provider, and in the provider you will pass the value which child wants to consume. Okay, here it has a value, and you can pass the value whatever you want. It can be count or anything. We have seen this in the previous example that you can initialize the count, something like this, count and set count. Use state and count is initialized with 0, and you can pass the value of count here. Okay, so here you can just pass the count values, count, and in this what I can do is to access the count, const value count, use context, and I just need to pass the provider shared context. So this count is nothing but this value it is representing. So whatever you are passing, that is coming in the count. So I will be able to access it like this. Plain and simple, this was the first hello world kind of example. We talked about how to use context hook, and we are actually using this with use state. If you wanted to use it with a use state, then you can actually pass both the things, and here you can get count and set count both. And on the on click, what you can do is you can actually do a set count, and you can pass whatever the current count is plus one. Okay, so what you are doing is we are calling set count method, which is defined in the parent component. We are able to access set count from this context. So from context, we are getting two things, count and set count, right? This is just another example how you can use context and use state both together. Now, what we want is we want to delegate this functionality of updating counter to a reducer function, right? So there will be a reducer function which will take care of this. We still have this provider. In the provider, we are going to pass the initial state. Consider that we are just passing only counter. So we can just directly access the count here, and we can print it here. This is plain and simple example. Now if you try to extend it, what we are trying to do is, let's say I want to create my own reducer function, and I will dispatch these two different actions like increment and decrement instead of calling these methods. Right, so what I can do is I can write one reducer function. That reducer function we have written earlier also, which is actually taking care of updating the count, increment and decrement action dot type, and here in this state dot count we are increasing by one. So based on that action increment and decrement, we are returning the state. This is the reducer function. Now instead of use state hook, we can use reducer hook. Okay. So this is how we write it. In use reducer, we have a state, current state of the reducer function, and dispatch. Through this dispatch, we will be able to dispatch increment and decrement. So we can actually remove this use state now, and we will be passing, in this context, we will be passing two things, our state and dispatch. Same thing we have seen with the use state hook. Now we are just replace this with the use reducer hook. We are passing state and dispatch. So whatever you are passing in the provider, the consumer will be able to access it. Consumer can access state, consumer can access dispatch, and it can actually dispatch a method which will update the state with the help of this reducer function. We are using this use reducer hook. What we are doing is we are passing the initial state. So let's say initial state is zero. Okay. And reducer function we have written already. So state and dispatch. So initially the state will be zero. Dispatch function, through the dispatch you can call increment and decrement. Now you have put that in the provider. That means wherever I'm consuming it, I should be able to access it. Okay. So this provider has a children counter. So counter can have the consumer written there. And inside the counter, we will write our consumer. That consumer will be simple. We can access state and dispatch from the same context. So here we are using shared context, and in shared context provider, we have set these state and dispatch. So same thing we are getting here, state and dispatch. So what state is having? State is having one property, which is count. So initial state of our component is the count is 100. So instead of making this, we can make this simple an object. Count is zero. Okay, this is the initial state. And now state.count it is updating and just plus one or minus one. Now, how can I access the count? Simple, I got the state, which is an object, I can access count. If I wanted to do increment and decrement, it is very simple. I can directly call the dispatch function, dispatch and type. So we just need to pass type. This is the dispatch function we are calling on the on click, and here we are passing type. Type can be increment and decrement based on what you have written here. This is one button. Another button is a decrement. This is minus minus. This would be plus plus. So there are these two buttons we have, and what they are doing is they are updating the state with the help of useReducer through this context. So if you just simplify it, it's doing the same thing. You are passing something to the context and it is able to access it, and it is just triggering that action. State means you are passing some data. Dispatch means here this dispatch belongs to useReducer. So with the help of this dispatch, I will be able to update the state which is kept inside a reducer. Okay, whenever the new state is coming, your state object will update. Same state object we are passing through the provider to the consumer, so count will get updated. Okay, if we just try to see this code, here we are using this app, export default app. We can also see this, how it is running. If you have any error, then we'll fix it. Okay, so const app, export default app, what it is. Identifier f has already been declared. Okay, we have two components with the same name. This should be the parent component, this should be counter only. I changed the wrong one. Now, so you see this counter is getting updated. Now if you just try to inspect it, these are very basic examples but gives a lot of clarity to us how React works, right? These particular hooks are working. So here I have the context provider. In the provider I have two things, value and dispatch function, and in the state I have a count. So this dispatch function I am triggering when I'm clicking onto it. This you are actually updating the state, and that state again getting populated in your component. This is my counter component. It is accessing the context, and that context has two things, state and dispatch function. Dispatch we are calling. With the help of dispatch, we are able to, this is the reducer hook we are calling, right? Reducer hook A is maintaining count is 14, but when you click on it, this reducer count is getting updated, right? So this is actually one of the nice example. You can have some kind of a store through the reducer. That store you can pass the initial state and dispatch. Dispatch is just a method using which you can call all these methods. Action.type, type, increment, decrement, update, reset. All these you can trigger from your child components. Only the thing is you have to pass this state and dispatch through the provider. So all the consumers, I mean all the child components, counter one, counter two, or anything which is written inside this provider would be able to access this state and dispatch, same as counter. I'm using use context hook to access this context, and I'm getting two things from there. Using destructuring state and dispatch, I got the count, and using dispatch, I am dispatching increment and decrement function, which is indirectly updating the state and making your count updated. Okay, these kind of same kind of examples, we will cover one more, like how you write this in real world application. Okay, like you have some kind of a user data being populated, you have a one common store, you are passing the initial state and that dispatch function, your child components from a different places are updating that store, right? Okay, so let's talk that in the next video. Thanks everyone.